In this video, I will show you how to set up an integration between Shopify and Ongoing WMS. So you start with finding Ongoing WMS on the Shopify App Store, and then you'll click this button. It'll say either log in to install or just install. I will be prompted to input my credentials for Shopify. And in here I have a test shop for development purposes. Now I'm at Ongoing's landing page for the Shopify integration, where you will paste in the URL to your system and then enter username and password. I will do this for an admin user, but you can also do it for a customer account login if you're a customer to a 3PL and want to be onboarded with the Shopify integration. Then you have this third option, try Ongoing WMS free of charge. If you click that and enter your email, you will get automatically access to a test system of Ongoing with your Shopify data inside. All right, I paste the URL to my system and then I click login. Then I'm taken to the integration page for Shopify in Ongoing. So I will have to select a goods owner, and then I'm going to choose this one, Shopify goods owner. And then a location in Shopify, which should be connected to Ongoing. So I'm going to do this one, shop location. I know that I have an order on that. It's in my Shopify test store. However, we will connect Ongoing to one warehouse in location in Shopify. If you want all three or all of your locations in Shopify to be connected to the same goods owner in Ongoing, you will have to reach out to your representative here. And then you will want to have this checked to fetch orders from Shopify. Here you can see what statuses you want to have. I will have authorized and paid. I'll just go with the default and order statuses. You can choose here. But you see that you can take any statuses or combination of statuses that you want. So use discount allocations on the line item in Shopify to calculate the line price in Ongoing WMS. You can keep that. Then these are important. The information about fulfillments and returns to Shopify. So usually you will have automatic here, and you can do this in development or test phase as well. Then you have to be careful that you don't process orders in Ongoing WMS, because if you do, then you will send back the status to Shopify. So if you're testing, yeah, use this, but don't process orders just yet until you're live. Or if you really know what you're doing, just keep on processing them, and we will sync in between Shopify and Ongoing with a 15-minute interval per default. All right, and I want to fetch my products from Shopify. And inventory levels, you have to be careful with that. Note, do not activate this if the inventory levels in Ongoing WMS are zero. This will wipe out Shopify's inventory levels. So the way to do this is you set up the integration, you bring in the deliver in goods in Ongoing, and then you check this button so you can do stock corrections and stuff like that. This one, connect additional Shopify apps to Ongoing WMS. If you check that, you'll see about a bunch of apps that are also supported. I refer to the integration page for Shopify and Ongoing to get more information. And now when I click create, the data will be exported into Ongoing WMS from Shopify. So if I now go to warehouse and articles, I will see my articles from Shopify coming in here. And if I go to order list, I should see one order that is open. And other data that comes is suppliers and customer. This will be from the orders, and I didn't put a customer name on that specific order, but it's still there. And the default interval to sync is 15 minutes. I will also show you a workaround for that if you want to trigger the integration directly. Let's say I have my Shopify store here and I create a new product. Let's call it new product. And then I'll just save. So added a new product, so it should be available here, new product. And then now I want to get it in ongoing. So I can, now I can either wait up to 15 minutes or I can go to this one, custom import. And then integration or email dispatch, and I'll just click import here. And then the integration is triggered and I got a new product in here. So if we go to warehouse article, then I have my new product here. So I mentioned the ongoing integration page for the Shopify integration. Here you will find more information and also all of our other integrations, and we have plenty. Yeah, that's it for this video. Thank you very much. Thank you.